Well, that was my fault. Somebody forgot to plug the phone in. Or somebody tripped over the cord. Whoever tripped over the cord owes $25. Beautiful. That's 95 south. And then you want me to take 85 north. Doing all right? GPS is telling me to take 85 south. Why? We want 85 north. So you never do what GPS says. GPS is okay as a general guide, but when people follow GPS blindly, that's how they end up driving on beaches and junk like that. But then, even if you do follow GPS and all that stuff, you should be smart enough to realize that when you get to something that doesn't look right, don't just keep driving on it and say, oh, GPS said okay. You know what I mean? I guess we'll let this guy over. I know one time that GPS tried to, yeah, he said thank you. One time the GPS tried to route me to a 7-ton bridge, and it's like, no, you don't go on a 7-ton bridge. But we were smart enough to look at and read the signs, you know what I mean? GPS is okay to use as a guide, but use your common sense first. I don't remember where that was, some back road, and GPS told me to take a left here, but there were big old signs that said 7-ton bridge 1 mile ahead. And it's like, I don't know what the GPS is thinking, but we're not doing that. I will never, for the life of me, figure out why people don't think things through. You know? Like that one big truck that ended up in a state park or a city park out in the middle of nowhere. Did he not think that, gee, this road is skinny and it looks like a golf course road? Did he like not use his brain at all? You gotta use common sense. Oh wait, nobody's got common sense anymore. One lady, GPS sent her to a 100 plus year old steel truss bridge, historic bridge, 8-ton limit, sign on it said 8-ton limit, and of course she climbed on it and it collapsed. But looking at the pictures, the mirrors were scraping the metal girders and stuff. I'm thinking, number one, did you not see that 8-ton bridge? Number two, did you not think that as low as that bridge was and as skinny as that bridge was, you thought it was still A-okay for you to be on there? And people did ask her, why did you like not stop? Well, her answer was she didn't know how heavy 8 tons was. I'm sorry. You're driving a 40-ton commercial vehicle. Shouldn't you know how much your truck weighs? Nothing. Nothing should ever take priority over your own instincts and common sense. at Birmingham 2 days in a row and Atlanta 2 days in a row. Kia thingy that just passed us. It's a DoorDash. And I have read a lot of horror stories about DoorDash. So my question is, have you ever used DoorDash? I did one time, I forgot where. I did one time. The lady brought my food to me. And I said, hey, where's my drink? Oh, I gotta go back to the car and get it. So she went to the car and got it. And when she brought it back to me, the straw was already in the cup. And it looked like there was about, I don't know, two thumbs worth. And I said, why is the straw in there? She goes, well, I didn't drink anything of it, if that's what you're worried about. It's like, yeah. But I've not heard anything good about DoorDash. And a bit about, if you don't tip them 50%, they don't deliver your food to you and all that other mess. I don't know. I did see a picture of an Uber Eats driver sitting in a toilet stall with an Uber Eats bag right next to him. And I'm thinking, really? You're going to go to the bathroom with my bag of Uber Eats? Good example of why we cook all our own food. We've got all sorts of our own food. And I can have it anytime I want. No need to bring anybody bring me food. Plus, I'm not going to be held hostage because somebody thinks they deserve a $20 tip for a $10 food item. This homie don't play that game. Years ago, before it's a joke or serious or what. But I was reading, and I read it in two different places, but doesn't mean it's real. I don't know. You know, these self-checkouts, all the companies go to self-checkouts, which I don't really like. You know, it's, I don't know, if I'm going to give you money, the least you could do is hire somebody to take my money. But anyways, I heard that Walmart and other stores, Target and whatnot, so many people steal through the self-checkouts. And actually the news report that I was watching, documentary on it, showed this one lady. She had this little barcode thing that she pulled off of something else. A big old case of diapers, which I'm sure is pretty expensive. She scanned some other little UPS tag she held over it. And she laughed and she said, guess what? I just rang this up for 35 cents. Big old box of diapers. Anyways, Walmart is talking about using, if you're going to use self-checkout, they're going to charge you $19. And I'm thinking, wait a minute, you put self-checkout there because you want people to use self-checkout. But now, people have been stealing from you, so you're going to punish people and you're going to charge them $19 extra as a service charge for using self-checkout. I don't know if that's accurate or not. What if you just bought $5 worth of veggies for your dinner, and then you get charged $19 at the self-checkout? So I don't know if that's a true story, a bogus story, or what, but I think all of that mess is just getting out of hand. I just buy everything I need at Costco or Aldi's, you know, sometimes Meijer's. I do not believe and tipping automatically. And we got a big brake check. For example, somebody reported gas pumps are now asking for tips. You know, or self-checkouts are asking for tips. I'm dead set against that. No human interaction. But you want me to tip? That ain't happening. The Pizza Hut many years ago. I got paid $1 an hour. And the company expected you to make up the rest of your hourly wage through tips. I'm against that. Always have been. I think the company you work for should pay you the minimum wage and tips should be extra. Don't like, well, just my opinion. I also don't give a tip among everybody that works. It doesn't reward the people that do good service. You know what I mean? So if you have a good service, that waitress has to give her money and her rewards to other people. How do you distinguish the good waitresses from the bad? You know what I mean? not starting any fights. That's not what discussions are for.
Thank you.
74 degrees and I'm freezing to death. Suck some of this cold air out. Warning, 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 window's gonna open. Warning, 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 window's gonna open. Thank you. past the Ace Hardware store. Anybody remember Western Auto? Do they even have Western Auto anymore? Big ol' empty warehouse on the right. You know, it took us several truck stops to find parking last night. But remember, they want 80,000 more trucks on the road. I don't know where they expect them all to park. Thank you. guess that guy in the left lane don't want to go through the scales. Truck bypass, yay. long time ago. I spent the night here, and I walked up to the hill, and I also walked down by the water. It was pretty cool. All right, disaster averted. Yeah. Mr. Professor Math IQ, part-time, full-time.